What's good, guys? Whoa, voice, puberty, second 24. What's good, guys? It's Marcel J. Welcome back to the channel. If you're old or new, I'm about to react to literally one of my favorite top five artists of the moment. I'm obsessed. I love her. I'm about to see her at Afropunk in 2 months. Super stoked for that. Her name's H.E.R. Her real name's Gabby. I forgot her last name, but she's been in the game for years. She started off as a younger child star-ish. I really want to say she was in acting, but she's definitely been in music for years. Under Nick Cannon's incredible name, and then I think she's branched off from there into her own thing. And she's just dope as fuck. Her music literally speaks for herself. She's not one of these artists that I feel like I need to hype up with an introduction. It's just more let's listen to her, let's vibe out and just discuss our feelings. That's what's gonna go on in this video. I've poured myself a fresh tequila soda because it's not a thing, tequila soda. It's tequila and Sprite, but vibe out to three of my favorite songs from her. I think it's her debut, she's making it her debut album. She dropped 3 EPs over the past year or two. And then she just put them together and added a couple more songs. And yeah, I love her. Hopefully you guys love her. If you're checking this video out or you're new and I introduce you to her, either or dope. We're gonna start off with Avenue. And I think for this video, actually, no, we're just gonna go with the flow. So, Avenue. And she's extremely secretive and elusive. You don't see anything beyond her silhouette, and you'll see her face, but she always has shades on because she wants to keep her privacy. Kind of what Sia did, or still does. Focus on the music. The first date, I should have said what's wrong in the first place. I don't, cause you always taking it the wrong way. You won't listen, you're too busy playing 2K. I always been down, but you still sleep. And even though I said it now, you should have been peeped. I feel it in my soul, yeah, so deep. So deep, you should know that about me. Yeah. I just turned down your avenue. I had to, but I'm mad at you, yeah. You always say I got an attitude, oh. Yeah, but that's you, you was acting rude. I had to ask you if you had a few, cause you always say I got an attitude, oh. This song, the vibe and the production on the song reminds me of super late nights when I would be driving or riding the car when I was younger and an R&B station would be playing, and it would just be a really cool, just fucking soulful type song playing at 10 p.m. 11 p.m. and that's what I get. She's in the video, she's really just cruising to the dude's house, since she's gonna pull up, we don't know yet, but that's what I think of when I hear that song. I just want to be in a car cruising 2 a.m. most likely deep in my feelings about some situationship that that's not working out. And I love her because she writes all of her shit and you feel every single thing she's saying. But you relate to everything she's saying. I've had these moments, just pulled to your avenue. It's good. Let's keep playing it. Why you talking to me like you be like, why you always wanna be right? Oh, I just need the time that you came from. I just need to know that it's still mine. And the best way line. That you can't say my name don't seem right. But I know when to go and to stop at the green light. Oh, I just turned on your avenue. Piano, the knock, yes. And the video is so simple, but it perfectly fits the vibe of the song. So I'm the one that's out of place. I'm the one that's in the way. I don't communicate. I'm so spoiled. So I'm the one that need a break. You ain't stay in my place. But you the one who came home late. And I ain't loyal. That's you, yeah. That's you. That's you, yeah. That's you.
right here, like, yes, I'm here. I'm here for it. That's you, you was acting rude. I had to ask you if you had a few, cause you always say I got an attitude. Oh, attitude. Oh, that's you. You was acting rude. Is she gonna go in? This is just so fucking real. Stride pass, bypass the drama. That's Avenue. I think that's definitely my most favorite song from her, but that was also one of the first songs I heard. Cause I heard like, I heard Focus and Facts and all those. Jungle, her cover. We're not reacting to Jungle, but Jungle, oof, everything. That should have been her song, honestly. Like, she does it better than Drake. Fight me if you disagree. But no, Avenue was really, I was just like, yo, I actually really feel this shit. Like, let me go back and listen to everything. But next, we're gonna listen to Focus. Probably the song you're most familiar with. Rihanna approved. She put it on her Instagram story hella long ago, but like, this is Focus. That fucking harp. Do we have strings in the background? Do you hear this? I'm talking over it, but you know. You know the song. Big heart rear. Can you focus on me? Baby, can you focus on me? Hands in a soap. It's running and I keep looking at you, but I don't want to give up. Baby, I just want you to get up. Roll fucking angels. Wanting the dude that she's with to focus on her, to take 20 minutes out of his day to just give her his undivided attention that she deserves. Like, into it. Just focus on me. Can you focus on me? Baby, can you focus on me? Yo, if you've never gone through this feeling, or you've never been the person putting someone into this feeling, you're way too young. You need to live more. Baby, can you? Or maybe you're just in a ton of healthy relationships, which, you know, show me your tricks. Lazy or broke, no, we get this money, so I guess I can't complain. But I feel alone even when we're alone, and that don't cause a thing, but I don't want to give up. Some of her lines, man, they just hit you so deep. I just want you to get up. Focus on me. Can you focus on me? Oh, yeah. Baby, can you focus on me? Me. Can you focus on me? Baby, can you focus? Her voice, man. Just so many elements come together to make this so perfect. I know she's working on more music. I can't imagine how she's gonna elevate and become even better. I can't imagine how I'm gonna like react to all this shit live in August. Like, you see me Afroblack, like communicate, share some love, cause like I'm gonna be on a different level that day. But that was Focus. Focus is another, our fave. That was from the first EP. And the last song, Hopes Up, is going to be one of her newest songs that was on the debut album, All the Songs Coming Together. But it's definitely an album cut. I don't think she gets a lot of love because it's not single yet. And, you know, people don't really like listen to full-length albums. And not all people. Like, definitely you guys. I feel like you guys are the ones who fuck with albums and shit. But I feel like a lot of people are also very into only singles or EPs, just short shit. And, like, I just want, like, give me a story, give me a narrative. And Hopes Up, that's it, Avenue is my favorite. Hopes Up would be a close second. And it was a song that I've neglected for so long. Like, it took me, I think, maybe even months of listening to the album and not realizing how much I really fuck with Hopes Up. And then one night I was listening to it and I was just in the right space to really get the lyrics. And I was like, well, this hits me. Like, and I'll talk, but just know I fuck this one heavy. It's always so chill too. I hope she keeps that. Like, she can change it up, of course, but just keep this like vibe.
I know what you're doing when you're giving me a rush. I know I'm only chasing in lust, feeling too high. Got you on cloud nine.
Yes, come on. Looking at this song right now in the moment, I feel like it's about her wanting a night, you know? She's leaving in the morning. You guys, obviously, her and the guy she's with, they're not into anything serious at the moment. She just wants a literal moment with someone that she fucks with. And get it from both perspectives. The perspective of wanting that one night with one person. Wanting that one night with a person, but also being that person who is dealing with the having someone who's leaving, who's like kind of not abandoning you, but like someone that you're not gonna see for a while. Like, she's busy, she's on fucking tours around the world, she's doing her thing, and you know, don't get your hopes up for something serious, but like, we can have tonight. That's what I think of. If I got that wrong, like, let me know, because whenever I listen to the song, I'm just vibing to it, and then the chorus comes, I'm just like, yes, I'm into it. But yeah, let's get into the song some more.
I mean to lead you on, you know, we both want the real thing, no demo, same for life.
This ain't for life, but honestly, what is, you know, when it comes to love relationships, like, for the most part, they're fade to end. Like, they may last for a couple years, they could last for fucking decades, but at the end of the day, they end. They end from death, they end from just like someone being over it and moving on to someone else. But I'm learning when it comes to relationships and situationships and everything in between, to enjoy the moment, appreciate the person that I have for the time that I have with them, but also to not get too attached or too, or feel like I deserve to have this person for the rest of my life, because I don't. Like, you know, we need to be together for as long as we need to. But if we don't need each other, we don't want each other, like, why drag the moment along? I think about that too when listening to the song. Like, there's just so many layers, you know? Let's keep this going. The song's almost over.
Don't get your hopes up.
little bit. Solid song. The whole album solid. Please give it a listen if you haven't already. If you're a fan, let's just like gush about her in the comments. Tell me your favorite songs. Yeah, tell me if you guys know if she's working on anything new. Also, let me know, because I feel like I've heard her say that. Like, also, maybe not. Maybe that's just my, like, my hopes. Me trying to get my hopes up for it. But, yeah, that was the reaction. If you enjoyed her as much as I do, give me a thumbs up. If you enjoy the videos, you want to see more of my face every week, definitely subscribe to the channel. New videos come in weekly. I don't want to put days on it, because, like, I have days on my mind when I, like, recording and posting, but I also, there's weeks where I just want to post literally every day, so, you know, I like to be a surprise for you guys, you know, just so you know, like, 50,000 fucking times, but you just go on YouTube, you see, oh, Marcel just posted something new, like, oh, I fucked this artist, let me click, you know, I'm done. But yeah, subscribe to the channel if you enjoy seeing my face, you enjoy hearing my commentary on music. Got some recommendations for me, definitely leave them in the comments. I'll get it to them in the future. I'm always looking at that shit. Like, someone told me to react to, from the Mariah video we've gone together, someone told me to react to her breakdowns and like her best singing moments, and I'm actually really interested in reacting to those. It's just, you know, I gotta find time to do it. So recommend something, I'll most likely do it. But that's it. I'm Marcel J. Thank you for checking this video out. I'll see you guys in the next one. On to the next. Peace.